Well, U.S. Special Forces were unable to capture a leader of the Al-Shabaab group in an assault in Somalia. The action was carried out in response to last month's mall massacre in the Kenyan capital, Nairobi. Navy SEALs attacked the senior Al-Shabaab commander's seaside villa in the southern town of Barawe. A U.S. military official has confirmed that they did not get their target. It was initially reported that they had captured the Al-Shabaab leader in the pre-dawn assault. An Al-Shabaab spokesman claimed that the militants beat back the U.S. assault. The raid came 2 weeks after Al-Shabaab claimed responsibility for the assault on an upscale shopping center in Nairobi, which claimed scores of lives. Well, to discuss that a bit further, we're now joined by Mr. Abayomi Azikiwe, who is the editor of the Pan-African Newswire, and he's now joining us on the line from Detroit. Mr. Azikiwe, as always, thanks for joining us. Now, how do you go through, what do you understand from this entire story? Is the United States now pretty much entrenched in carrying out military action in Africa?
Yes, and specifically in regard to Somalia, they have been engaged in this type of activity for the last 6 or more years. After the Ethiopian government entered Somalia in late 2006, the United States, as well as Britain, carried out airstrikes in the country during early 2007. They have a drone operation that is set up in Somalia, as well as a CIA station. They have carried out drone attacks repeatedly in Somalia over the last 3 years. So this effort to carry out a targeted assassination against the Al-Shabaab leader is really nothing new in regard to the U.S. Foreign policy in regard to Somalia.
So then, Mr. Azikiwe, why this concentration on Africa?
Well, of course, we have to look at the mineral resources of Africa. Somalia now is undergoing an economic transformation. There are Western multinational oil firms that are there now that are drilling and exploiting oil. The United States, over 20 years ago, it was reported that they had attempted or had purchased large oil concessions in Somalia. So it's strictly dealing with the economic interests of the United States. All along the East African coast, in Somalia and Kenya, Tanzania and Uganda, large findings of oil as well as natural gas have taken place just over the last year, both inland as well as off the coast in the Indian Ocean. So they're clearly out to defend what they perceive to be huge potential in regard to profit-making as it relates to the oil and natural gas industry, and also the strategic significance of Somalia as well, because it's located right on the Gulf of Aden, which is a strategic waterway where billions upon billions of dollars worth of goods are transported on a weekly basis.
Okay, we'll leave it there for now, but of course, as always, we do appreciate your insight. That was Mr. Abayomi Azikiwe speaking to us live from Detroit.